Reagan Glazier, CEO and Director of Neotech Metals, joins us now. And Reagan, you've put out a very interesting independent report, a mineralogical study on the Hecla-Kilmer mineralization. Can you just tell us, first off, tell us about the testing and the results?
Yeah, a very fun and exciting story for Neotech. The backbone of this project being that the apatites in our deposit in Northern Ontario are supercharged with these rare earth elements that allow for us to possibly tackle the biggest problem in rare earths right now, which is the processing bottleneck.
So tell us specifically, having this apatite-hosted type of rare earth element mineralization, what specifically does that mean for investors?
The big issue within the rare earth sector, again, being the processing or the lack of it and how difficult they are, is addressed with these apatites in our deposit. So just by sheer geological luck and uniqueness, we have a system that geochemically allows us for low temperature and low reagent use processing of these rare earths in our deposit.
Can you tell us on a global scale, how significant is this discovery about the mineralization? Can you compare and contrast Hecla-Kilmer with other similar projects?
Well, within North America, it's very unique in that all of the other deposits are based around the typical monazites and bastnasites that are currently being explored and developed. So for us to think outside the box a little bit here and approach it from a different angle gives this a completely different spin on what a conventional rare earth project may possibly be. And then within a global setting, it's very significant as well, as 92% of rare earths were processed in China in 2024. This could be a clear pathway to allowing us to deviate from that.
And Reagan, what are the consequences of this discovery about the mineralization for your advancement of the Hecla-Kilmer project? Does it change the timeline at all?
The findings are quite significant in that, paired with our recent drill campaign, we conducted about 8,000 meters. We just concluded that a couple weeks ago. Going in, we're going to be doing a more expansive mineralogical testing campaign across the full suite of our deposit, being a 3.5 kilometer geophysical anomaly. We're going to be targeting all of these apatites in future drill campaigns so that we can eventually work it into an economic study paired with our resource estimate, hopefully Q2 2026, for sure 2026, in that we could have a possible low operating cost that could beat a lot of the conventional, more refractory mineralization styles for rare earth deposits.
And when do you expect to be getting back on the ground at that project? What are those next practical steps?
Yeah, we just finished drilling a couple of weeks ago in northern Canada. Temperatures were down to about minus 35 degrees Celsius. So while everything's frozen, we have all of our core samples at the lab getting worked on, in which we'll be incorporating that into our resource estimate. So once our resource comes out, we'll be reanalyzing their models and looking at the highest priority targets for both infill and expansion. And yeah, hopefully a late spring or early summer kickoff for our next exploration field campaign would be going underway.
And while we're staying tuned for that news, I'm sure plenty of us will be heading out there and Googling deeper into the significance of this apatite-hosted rare earth mineralization you've got on your hands now.
Super. Thank you so much.